Tegaza, tegaza. How you doing, guys? I'm fine. If you are new, please welcome to Gogo Makgabo spiritual channel. Please sit down and relax with us. Enjoy with us. Okay, today I have 6 ways I want to share with you. 6 natural ways to attract money and abundance into your life. Okay, how you going to attract money and abundance into your life naturally? I'll tell you. Okay, first item, I have bags and wallets. I want you to know that I've been using this for a while and it's working for me. Okay, yes, I've been using some of this. I've been using them for a long time, but then I added some of them, you know, some months back, and now I can see that it's working for me. That's why I've decided that I want to share this with you. And I know that after this video, you're going to do the same, and you are going to be successful. You are going to attract money into your life, even if it's not that big money, you know, something small, just to buy some food and put on the table for your kids, for your family. That's all that we want, you know, for our needs. Okay, number one, I have bags and wallets. How will bag and wallets attract money into your life? First thing, by making sure that your bag and your wallet are always nice, clean and tidy. Okay, make sure that you remove all those things, you know, all those papers, those things that are not needed in your bag, remove them. Put everything in its own compartment. Your lipstick, so that when you want it, you know where to find it. Your car keys, put them where you'll know that when you want them, you will find them. Okay, make use of a beautiful and a nice bag and also a nice wallet, because you don't want a worn out one. Nope. A torn bag, nope, you don't want that one, because it's already you know, torn, and it doesn't look nice at all. Yes, it looks very old, so it's not gonna attract any money, you know, it won't. So make sure that if yours is old, buy a new one, even if it's not expensive. A simple one, simple nice one. Okay, yes, those colorful ones, yeah, buy them, and you will attract money into your life. Okay, remove any bills and receipts from your bag, because you know why? Bills and receipts represent the money that is going out of your wallet, the money that is going out of your bank. So you must remove them, because as soon as you come back from your shopping, yes, make sure that you remove them. You don't need them, unless if you want to save them, but don't put them in your bag. Put them somewhere. Okay, okay. Do not put your debit orders at the same compartment with your credit cards and your clothes retail cards, because your credit cards, your clothes retail cards, they represent the money that is going out of your wallet, the money that is not yours. Okay, so make sure that you put them separately from your debit cards. Do not put them together, because that negative energy from the credit card is going to, you know, impact on your, you know, on the positive one, you know, and that positive will turn into a negativity. Money will come slowly, money will go out very fast, and life will be very, very bad. Okay, and then put at least one paper money, anything from 100 rand if you can afford, or 200 rand. If not, you can put 10 rand or 20 rand, but I wanted you to put at least 100 rand or a 50 rand, something which is, you know, yeah. Because big money attracts more money into your life, but low money is going to attract less into your life. Okay, make sure that you do the same with the coins. Also, put some coins, you know, make sure that you put some coins in your wallet, you know, anything from 1 rand, 2 rand, 5 rand, you can just mix them, but don't put the bronze ones, 1 cent, 2 cents, 50 cents. Nope, those ones are a no-no. They're going to attract low money into your life. Okay, and before you do this, before you put this money into your wallet, make sure that you pray for it. Okay, I'm coming for this. I think it's item number 5. Yes, or item number 4. You're going to pray for it. Okay, yes, you're going to pray for it, and then put it somewhere, yeah, in your bag, in your wallet nicely. This is what you're going to do. Okay, and then one more other thing, never ever put your bag or your wallet on the floor. Never. A woman's bag, a lady's bag, doesn't sit on the floor. Never put it on the floor. It will attract low energy, low money into your life. If like you're in a restaurant, put it nicely, safely on the table. If you're driving your car, put it on the other seat. If maybe you're the passenger, you can put it on your lap. Okay, don't put it on the floor. Nope, it's not good at all. Okay, item number two, keeping money at home. Same thing that you're doing with your bag and your wallet, you're going to do it at home. Make sure that you always have money at home. Make sure that you always have 100 rand at home. This is the one that you're not going to use. You're going to pray for it, you know, that 100 rand and those coins, you know, the silver coins, you're going to pray for them, put them nicely somewhere at home, somewhere. You'll only use them if, like, yeah, you can see that today I have no choice. But make sure to replace them whenever you have money, okay? And never ever leave a bronze coins lying around in your home. Nope. When you're sweeping, if you see a bronze, maybe a 50 cents, a 10 cents, a 5 cents somewhere on the floor, pick it up. Make sure that you always put them together, you know, in one thing, maybe in a container, in a piggy bank, anything that you can put them in, you know, and you'll make sure that when they are many and you'll take them and deposit them into the bank or exchange them at the bank. This is what you're going to do. Okay. And number three, I have being generous. They say that a hand that gives also receives. Okay. Yes. So make sure that you share what you have with other people. Do not share with those who can afford, you know. You must share with the needy, because those ones they can afford, they have already. Make sure that you share with the needy, you know, so that they'll also be able to buy that food. This is what you're going to do. Sometimes even if it's not about giving them money, but you can buy something for them, maybe some food, some clothes, or even if it's your clothes, you know, the ones that you are no longer using, you can always share with them. This is being generous. But do not do this just for people to see you. Nope. Just for, you know, showing up that we know you're being generous. Nope. You're going to do this because this is what comes from your heart. You must give from your heart. You must give if your heart tells you to. This is what you're going to do. Okay? And do not give because you want to receive. Nope. Just give. Even if you don't receive, but you know that God has seen. Okay. And one day, I'll be given something. Even if it's not on this earth, somewhere, God will give me something. God will give me an eternal life. Yes. Number four, money manifestation. I've told you last year on a video about manifestation that you need to manifest. If you want to, you know, to achieve some things in your life, make sure that you manifest on them so that you are able to achieve them. So soon I'll do a practical manifestation video so that you'll see how we do manifestation. And thereafter, I'm going to let you do the same at home. You know, manifest on anything that you want, and then as soon as you achieve that, and then you're going to share it with us on your tube. This is what you're going to do. Maybe it can even be one of our competition. Maybe we'll have the winner there. We'll see about that. Make sure that when you want things, manifest on them. Pray on them. Ask the Almighty God. Ask your spiritual guides or spiritual angels to give you what you want, to give you that money. When you're at peace, ask your ancestors to give you that money. This is what you're going to do. And yes, you will get that money. You will get it. I want you to know that it's okay to pray for money. Many verses in the Bible, they allow that. Check your Bible, you know, yes, check those verses, and you can use them when you pray. When you pray for money, there are lots of money prayers in the Bible which you can use to pray for that money that you're going to keep in your wallet, in your home. Yes. And that money that comes to you, when it comes to you, then knelt down and pray for it and thank your ancestors. Thank God. Thank the Almighty for this money that they've given to you. Okay. Number five, having a purpose. I want you to know that even if you pray for that money, you know, even if you pray for God to give you that money, but if you don't have a purpose for that money, you don't know what you're going to use it for, then you won't get it. Make sure that when you do that, you know what you're going to do with it. And tell God, tell the Almighty God, tell your spiritual angels, your ancestors, what you want this money for. Make sure that you put your needs first and your wants will come later. okay? Yes, meaning that you need to have a valid reason why you want this money. Yes. Do not have selfish reasons, nope. Number six, having faith. I want you to know that if you don't have faith, whatever you're doing, even if it's small, every little thing that you're doing, if you don't have faith, then you won't achieve them. You won't. So for you to get this money, for you to do this, to attract this money, you need to have faith. When you start doing this, tell yourself that, you know what, I'm going to have money. This year, this in 2020, I'm going to have money, lots of it. I'll be having money to do 1, 2, 3. Have faith, believe in yourself, and you'll see, you will get it. Okay, that's all that I have, guys. This is what I've been doing myself. So make sure to do it and see. And you will respond on YouTube. You'll share with us how, you know, you were able to get that money that you've been wanting. Okay. And if, like, you know of any other ways to attract money, you can also share them with us. Thank you so much. For those of you who are new, please remember to subscribe and like my page. Okay. Thank you so much. Toguz.